This fluid status monitor is an attempt to sort of solve a dilemma that has perplexed clinicians for many, many years. And that's how to precisely determine what the right circulatory volume is for an individual. From one extreme, we've taken the physical exam, and we think that we can, by listening to your heart and your lungs, determine if you have the right amount of fluid. But when that's actually been studied, it's really no more sensitive than a flip of a coin.
DRIVE stands for Dynamic Respiratory Impedance Volume Evaluation, where DRIVE really excels is in saying exactly what blood is doing as it's doing it. You can absolutely, with DRIVE, track how much circulating volume a patient has by taking this new vital sign, this DRIVE vital sign, and combining it with the treatment outcomes we expect. We can use it as a new way of honing in on where do we want a patient to be and where are they currently.
So we've gone from something that's fairly large with a computer and a tabletop now to something that resembles a nano iPod, for example, that you can wear on your arm.
So the DRIVE wearable consists of a number of components. The heart of the matter is an impedance measurement chip.
So we're passing a small amount of electricity around the limb. As it moves through the limb, the current either moves faster or slower based on the amount of blood volume. So it's a very sensitive measure. So we can actually count your respirations and how deep you're breathing just by measuring this small amount of blood or moderate amount of blood that moves back and forth from your limb as you breathe.
What our system enables is a continuous measurement. It does it non-invasively, and it doesn't require any kind of expertise. This device, our device, is one of those devices that could be used by as experienced a physician that exists and as inexperienced a patient as there is. A patient can use this at home, they can use it at work. You just need to place the electrodes on the upper limb, and the software, the algorithms, all of our years of research will do the rest of the work for you.
Having a device like this that gives us more of a continuous stream of data is something we're most excited about. Patients and physiology are really dynamic. And so being able to follow patients throughout the course of their stay in the hospital and even monitor a patient's condition at home with a device like this is really, really exciting, because it really would provide something like hour-to-hour or minute-by-minute management if you needed that much data. And whether it's trauma, whether it's heart failure, whether it's sepsis, whether it's people with chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, these are all cases and challenges where knowing volume status on more than that snapshot basis would really be a game changer.
Where the electronic device is dissipating a lot of heat, and if the heat can't escape, that means the electronic device gets very hot. And when it gets hot, its performance suffers, and it also can have a reduced lifetime. We invented a way